When we locked down, we found out what Americans valued most. That paper. Toilet paper? Yeah, TP flew off the shelves faster than gushers on Epstein's Island. People were so desperate for rolls, they were to watch Weinstein wank into a weeping willow. It was a bit surprising. I mean, you'd think it'd be bread, eggs, pasta, but I guess the only thing these millennials eat is ass. I mean, everything was so confusing. Remember when Fauci first crawled out of his tree stump and told us not to wear masks? Then he sees his shadow and makes us mask up forever. We didn't know who to trust, so we started making up our own rules, like wearing latex gloves and wiping down more packages than Bob Kraft's masseuse. And when the official rules came in, they were great, because they were just common sense. Wash your fucking hands, cover your fucking mouth, don't eat beef and broccoli, and maintain a social distance of half the gap between Michael Strahan's teeth. Generally, everybody was willing to do it. Because look, there's no pandemic playbook. Politicians were trying to save lives, and they were erring on the side of caution. And then came the bullshit. L.A. Mayor and Spirit Airlines stewardess Eric Garcetti acted like an 80s movie villain and started filling up skate parks with more sand than Cleopatra's camel toe. Or remember when they yanked a surfer out of the sea? Is that the first time we've ever stopped a water border? They arrested a father for playing catch with his daughter, and now he's probably playing a whole different type of catch in jail. So, did these precautions really protect us from getting the virus? Probably not. And you know what? Maybe it did more harm, because when people saw the inconsistency in the rules, they began to question all the rules. And I get their skepticism. I mean, most politicians are spineless sociopaths plowing interns and suckling subsidies off of citizens. And you know what? Corona proved it. Remember that drug they said was a felony 2 years ago and gave Kamala her career? Well, now, it's an essential business, so I guess our prisons are filled with essential workers, and unfortunately, the only thing clapping at 7 p.m. is their cheeks. I haven't seen anything go from illegal to essential this fast since Kylie. Speaking of cheap plastic, California governor and inflatable fuckdoll Gavin Newsom ordered wineries in 19 counties to close. You know what Gavin didn't order close? His own fucking winery. Nothing says man of the people like owning a vineyard. There's a drought in California, and Gavin is hosing down his grapes like they're striving for civil rights in Selma. These dorks can't even follow their own rules. Yeah, Nancy Pelosi, who looks like she got a facelift from a taxidermist, was caught getting her Pan Am perm at a local hair salon that she ordered to shut down. And it turns out, being a piece of shit politician goes both ways, like Andrew Gillum in a motel meth orgy, which actually would have helped him win Florida. It's not just the left. The jerk-offs on the right are just as bad. I mean, Republican Senators Richard Burr, who looks like he ran for Senate to ban dancing, and part-time Muppet Kelly Loeffler got a secret briefing on the impending economic destruction of Corona, immediately sold their own stock, and then told everyone not to worry about Corona. Hey, Vanilla ISIS, these are the politicians you should be kidnapping. At the end of the day, money always trumps everything.